Hi everyone, my name is Charmaine and my aunt named me. It means song of joy. And later on, I found out that she named me this because she wanted joy in my life, because she suffered from depression for most of hers. Depression can affect anyone. In fact, one in six of us in this room right here will suffer from depression in our lifetime. The numbers are very sobering, but what's more alarming is that our current treatments don't always Our best therapies, they focus on challenging our irrational thoughts, our self-defeating behaviours, but they don't answer the hard question, why do we think or behave in this way? The therapy says that, well, our thoughts and behaviours, these are only pieces in the jigsaw puzzle of depression. In order to effectively treat it, we need to look at the missing pieces, things like our temperament, our childhood experiences, honest beliefs of ourselves, and also how we cope when things get rough. Because all this makes us who we are. It drives our life choices, and with it, our mental health or illness. So I wanted to know, hey, can this help us better understand and treat depression? But spoiler alert, every researcher has their own ideas on what the missing pieces are. And even when they decide on the key pieces, they measure it differently. So I did a two-part study. First, I mapped out all the relevant findings. And some of what I found was quite intuitive. So if you're a bit moodier by nature, or experience abuse as a child, you will be more vulnerable to depression in your life. But interestingly, it's not just about the extremes, but too much or little of something. Say parents who are emotionally very distant or very involved. Say a five-year-old boy, little moodier by nature, but his parents are very distant. So he has to cope because he has to, right? So he learns to repress his emotions, but then he carries this with him and ends up as a 40-year-old man, struggling to open up in a relationship because he's never learned how to. Or say an 8-year-old girl, same moody temperament, but with parents who are very controlling, overprotective. So fast forward 20 years, and you find her in one bad relationship after another, struggling because she doesn't believe that she can survive on her own. It's not that she can't, but she never had the chance to learn how capable she can be. Two very different pathways, same outcome of depression. So I tested this and my other hypothesis in a study among people who are depressed and not depressed. And I'm now analysing my data to see how well or poorly fits my hypothesis. But I'll let you in on a secret. The truth is that no one knows a piece or a thousand-piece puzzle. But the next time you see someone depressed, behaving or thinking a little irrationally, what we can do is to be a little more willing to understand. Because only then can we see. Thank you.